show you, this is a song. It's about an old man. Wants to sing just in a good choir. That's all he wanted, because he knew he wasn't gonna be here too long. So he just wanted to sing in the choir. But I'm not saying that the choir director looked over him. It's just that maybe sometimes you just see when you have your mind in the Lord, you can't say that somebody look over you. Because I know if I'm doing something for the Lord, I'm gonna try to do everything I can. I don't wanna leave nothing out. But I'm gonna sing this song. That it can happen to you. Or me, or anyone. And it goes something like this. It was a little church. Sitting down. Church, they had a choir, can sing real. Now that was an old Eagle man. Had been gone to that church for a mighty long time. Yeah, Sunday morning, he always made that choir director. He said, listen, won't you take me sing me a song? He said, I've got a song that I want to sing. You know what that choir director told him? He said, oh man, you too old to sing in this choir. They went to church the next Sunday morning, and they didn't see an old man sitting in a corner. But they went to church the next Sunday morning, they didn't see an old man sitting in the corner. You see, they get worried now. Someone, Lord, wanna do something for the Lord. Oh. a loser of the Lord.
Thank you. be the glory. Church, I want to let you know that God is real. And he said in his word that he would never leave us nor forsake us. And God is an everlasting to everlasting. The first and the last, the beginning and the end. We must recognize that the only thing that's real is God. Everything else shall pass. And this too shall pass. Amen. Always know that if you keep your hands in God, everything's going to be all right. And if anybody needs to know that, I need to know that right now. Yes. I'm going through the storm. Right. I'm coming out. Yes. I'm not listening to me today. Say, I'm going through the storm, but I'm coming out. Yes. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Coming out better than I went in. Yes. And my ladder will be greater than my beginning. Yes. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
God is so good.
Yes.
You have your Bibles. Turn with me to Haggai. Amen. In the book of Haggai, there is a word from the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. In the book of Haggai. Amen. Give you time to find it. I know that's a strange book. It's in the Old Testament. Amen. Haggai chapter 1. Much, but receive only a little. And when you brought it home, I made that love disappear. And when you brought it home, I made that love disappear. Why have I done this? It's because you hurry off to build your own houses while my temple is still in ruins. That's also why the dew doesn't fall and your harvest fails. And so, my command, everything will become barren. Your farmland and your pastures, your vineyards and your olive trees, your animals and yourselves, all your hard work will be for nothing. Zerubbabel and Joshua, together with the others who had returned from exile in Babylon, obeyed the Lord's messenger, spoke by his prophet Haggai, and they started showing proper respect for the Lord. Verse 13, Haggai then told them that the Lord had promised to be with them. So the Lord God all-powerful made everyone eager to work on his temple, especially Zerubbabel and Joshua. Last verse, and the work began on the 24th day of that same month. Grass withered, the flowers faded, but the word of the Lord shall stand forever. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I want to talk about a drought with a paper bag with holes in it. A drought with a paper bag with holes in it. Brothers and sisters, if I must make this plain in plain English where you can understand, we do know that a drought is when things dry up. It's a desert place. It's a vacant land with nothing able to grow because of a lack of moisture, lack of water, lack of frost. And a paper bag is a bag that when you go to Walmart and you purchase your items and you put it in a bag, but the bag don't have a hole in it. Y'all with me today? I'm gonna make it clear. So when we talk about a drought with a paper bag with a hole in it, we're talking about in our lives, there may be a drought in our lives. There might be a dry season in your life. There might be a place in your life where you might feel like you're in a desert. Where only the sun is beaming on you, but there's no water to drink. There's no marshes to wet your lips and no cool water to wet your tongue. There's no spring water flowing through the hills where you can make it through the desert storm. And the Lord is telling Haggai to speak to the people of Israel. Speak to my people and then inform them that there will be a drought in their lives, with a paper bag with holes in it when they make their earnings, because they are not serving me as I chose them to, because they are letting my house go to ruins. My house must be the first house that should be the best house, the church house. He teaches us that they are living in expensive homes and not paying no attention to his house. His house is in ruins. I think this is very fitting to speak about because our church anniversary is coming. I want to prepare you to be able to get a blessing. Amen. Because if you bless the Lord, thy God, God will in turn bless you. Amen. Not trying to toot my own home, but I just want to allow you to know that last year by this time, somebody knocked on my door and gave me a $10,000 check and said, this is for your ministry. In turn, gave it to my church. I wanted to bless my church. I gave it to the church, and I blessed the church.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Even though they cut my hours on my job, they cut my wages, I could have easily took that 10 grand and done something with it. I'm not missing. But my heart is for the church. My heart is for God. You know, and even though I was struggling a little bit to make ends meet, I still did not touch that money. See, some people don't fear God. I fear the Lord. Some people don't understand that the wisdom is to fear God. Amen. Amen. A drought situation, a bag with holes in it. We often wonder why our lives are not climbing the ladder like we should, because we're not doing what the Lord. Can somebody turn on the AC, please? Getting a little warm in here. We understand that we're living in the last and evil days, and we're living in a world where time is winding up, and where it appears that everything's right has gone out the window, everything wrong has come in the way. Amen. And it appears that boys, girl, and girls, boy, it appears that everybody want to be in cahoots with what's wrong. Amen. Amen. Haggai got a word from the Lord. He said, on the first day of the sixth month of the second year, that Darius was king of Persia. Yes. And the Lord told Haggai, amen, amen, the prophet, to speak this message to the governor of Judea, uh-huh, and to the high priest.
Yeah.
So Haggai told the governor Zerubbabel, uh-huh, amen, yeah, and the high priest Joshua,
yeah,
that the Lord all-powerful has said to them and to the people, yeah, you said this is the right time to build a temple for me. Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it is right for you to live in expensive houses. Amen. But you allow my house to go in ruins.
Uh-huh.
So what the Lord is telling the people of Israel, and what the Lord is telling you and I, is that we must take care of the house of God.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
We must take care of the church.
Yeah.
If you see something out of order, a piece of wood falling off, a window broke, or we need a new carpet, or maybe somebody needs to start up. Temple of God, right? Amen.
Amen.
So you must understand that your temple, as well as this temple, must continue to be in an upstanding position in the eyes of God.
Amen.
You can't just put anything in your temple, amen. You can't just be contaminated with everything in your temple, amen.
Amen.
You just can't be fill yourself up with the dirt and the dust of the earth.
Yeah.
Amen. You have to be holy because He said, I am holy. I wash you white in the snow with hyssop.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
So Zerubbabel had problems listening to Haggai.
Yeah.
He didn't want to take orders from Haggai because Haggai was a prophet.
Yeah.
Amen. But to God be the glory.
Yeah.
Haggai was only following the rules of the Lord.
Yeah.
And when Haggai heard the voice of God, he said to himself, he said, Lord, you want me to tell them this?
Uh-huh.
And he said, yes.
Uh-huh.
Go tell them to rebuild my temple. Because they started out building it after they came out of exile.
Yeah.
See, God had scooped them up because they were disobedient to God.
Yeah.
When you're disobedient to God, God has a way of scooping you up.
Yes.
And he brought them in chains to Babylon.
Yeah.
Where King Nebuchadnezzar was a monarch.
Okay.
King Nebuchadnezzar was a monarch. And what a monarch? A monarch is somebody that just don't care about nothing. Amen. A monarch will take you and pull your eyes out in front of your kids.
Yeah.
Amen. And cut your tongue off. Amen.
Yeah.
And he'll stick a sword up your nose. Amen. He'll put you on a horse backwards in chains and ride you until you fall off. Nebuchadnezzar just didn't care. The king and ruler of Babylon.
Uh-huh.
So he went to Israel and he stole all the young people, and that's where Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego got involved in. And
yeah.
Daniel, the lion's den, and all the rest of the story that you hear, which is true. And when Haggai told Zerubbabel and
yeah.
Joshua that they needed to build God's temple,
yeah.
they got distracted. You know how sometimes we get distracted
yeah.
when we're doing something for God?
Yeah.
The enemy has a way of distracting you and trying
yes.
to get you off beat,
yes.
trying not to keep you from going to church.
Yeah.
You know how the enemy try to make you not want to go to church?
Yeah.
Well, you have to understand that that's only a trick from the devil.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So King Nebuchadnezzar said, we're going to go to Israel,
uh-huh.
and we're going to steal all of the young people, all of the healthy, all of the good-looking people.
Yeah.
We're going to bring them to Babylon in captivity. And
yeah.
he kept them for 72 years.
Yeah.
And why did he keep them for 72 years? Because at the end of 72 years, he had to let them go because God made Nebuchadnezzar out of an example.
Uh-huh.
Nebuchadnezzar had fan-ears, claws like an eagle, he had hair like a wolf. Nebuchadnezzar was eating grass. And when he come out of his darkness, he said, you are the true and living God. God has to break us before he wins. God has to speak to us in his own infinite way. God has to take us sometime and roll us through the mud. Let us know that he's large and he's in charge. And there ain't no way of getting around him because he's too big. So it behooves each and every one of us to get our act together and know that we need to put God first. And if not, we're going to have a drought in our lives and we're going to have a paper bag with holes in it. Why are we going to have a paper bag with holes in it? Let's see what scripture says. Scripture's teaching us to say, think about what I said. This is God. But first, go to the hill and get home on my temple. He said, I made it disappear. Why do you think the Lord made things disappear out of your life? Why do you think that you can't keep money in your pocket? Because you got a hole in it. Why do you think that you have to continue to rob Peter to pay Paul? Because you're not doing what you're supposed to do in the house of the Lord. Come on, help me here today. Amen. I'm trying to help somebody get blessed today. So you know that you know that you know. Don't listen to the devil. Just tell about the church just wants your money. The preacher just wants your money. The devil is a lie. I mean, I can understand that that's all you got to put a dollar in the tray yet. But if you can, bless yourself. Don't let nobody fool you. It turns and it comes back to you double fold. Because you hurried off to build your own house while my temple is in ruins. Why is my temple in ruins? Because the people turned their back on the house of God. And our church anniversary is coming up, but we're not going to turn our back on the house of God. We're going to bless the house of God. If you want to receive a blessing, they may ask for one thing, double it. If you want to see a blessing, amen. Seed time harvest. Amen. Plant your seed so that you can reap a harvest.
Yes.
He said, well, hurry up along. That also we, why the dew doesn't fall on your harvest and your harvest fail.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. And so my command, I command everything will come barren.
Uh-huh.
What does he mean barren? Well, there's a drought in your life. Uh-huh. The Lord gonna put a drought in your life.
Yes.
Because you don't want to do what's right.
Yes.
You come to church sometime.
Yes.
Come to church. Easter or Sunday, I ain't trying to knock on nobody's shoes. I'm just trying to help somebody. You gotta force yourself in the church. Get in the church. Not only get in the church, but do something. Find a place to be a doorkeeper. Be a fire singer. Be a Christian. Be a missionary. Be a deacon. Be a deacon. Be a musician. Do something in the house of God. And you will see the difference in your life. Of the world will dissipate. All the things of the world will fall away. Because you are now wrapped up, tied up, and tangled up in the will of God. Are you with me today? Am I helping somebody? You gotta know how to fool the devil. You gotta keep your hand in the master's hand. Because in God's hand, it don't change. It stays the same. Amen. What is he saying? He said, your farmland and your pastures and your vineyards and your olive trees, your animals, and you yourself.
Oh, yeah.
All the hard work you've done is for naught.
Yeah.
Why? It's because you're not paying attention to the church.
Yeah.
The church needs us to keep the church going.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Moving forward in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
So Zerubbabel and Joshua, together with the others, had to return from exile in Babylon. And spoke to the prophet Haggai and started showing proper respect for the Lord.
Yes.
Folks don't have proper respect for the Lord these days.
Yes.
They got more respect for Lil Wayne and 49 Cent. Y'all ain't listening to me.
Yes.
Say amen.
Yes.
People got more respect for Beyonce, whatever her name is, than they do they have for the Lord. The prophet. prosperous in his day.
Yes.
Hey, God then told them that the Lord had promised to be with them.
Yes.
The Lord had already promised to be with us.
Yes.
No matter what we're going through,
yes,
it's critical to know that the glory of the Lord is with us.
Yes.
To God be the glory.
Yes.
I went to have church 7 days a week, I'll be here.
Yes.
I went to have church every day of the year, I'll be here.
Yes.
But you got to understand something, the church got to come out of the flesh,
yes,
into the spirit. Storm, but I'm coming out. I'm coming out
We're going to stand and wait for you, understand? And then maybe somebody, if there's somebody that want to come on worship, I would plead that you would walk with them and escort them this way. If we don't want to walk alone, maybe you want to come and stand in the gap for somebody. A brother, a sister, a son, a daughter, a husband, a wife. Maybe you might just want to come just to say, I'm coming because I feel the need of prayer. Is there one today? Is there one today? You can come now. Bible says, come as you are. No shame, form, or fashion. Is there a young person that want to come? You might be pastor, you might be shame, you might be shy. Don't allow the enemy to make you feel uncomfortable.
Say,
save me.
I
Sunday morning. The choir went to say, he said, Lord, oh Jesus, that I've never, 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 oh Jesus, oh Jesus. He said, I've never, 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 never. Let y'all go by yourself.